The place, New York City. The time, the 1980s. Crime was on the rise, the city was in turmoil and facing financial oblivion. Times Square was filled with porno cinemas and hookers, and worst of all, a certain Donald Trump was using tax loopholes to buy a load of Manhattan real estate at bargain basement prices. Chances are, if you grew up in the 1980s, you grew up thinking of New York as a lawless, tag-covered, punk-infested crime hole. Video games were quick to jump on this look, incorporating pixel-perfect garbage-littered streets, Mohicans, knife crime, burning trash barrels, and sadistic promiscuous women into a slew of side-scrolling beat-em-ups. These games, such as Double Dragon and River City Ransom, lent heavily on the vigilantism of the era, itself boosted by the formation of infamous groups such as the Guardian Angels, a gang founded to protect law-abiding citizens on New York's cesspit of a subway system. Common throughout these games was a heroic male protagonist striding into town like a white knight to win the war on drugs and undesirables. Walking into a frightening maze of back alleys, you're a Galahad in Levi's armor, a Gary Cooper for the MTV generation. As was the style at the time, the only defense against the moral lassitude of the young and ethnically diverse was a punch in the mush and a kick in the nethers. In the subgenre of the scrolling beat-em-up, it was always you against the world, might making right. And most of the people you're fighting and righting were white kids with mohawks, coded as drug users. These weren't the trustworthy boomers with their Don Draper suits, picket fences, legal amphetamine use, white-collar crime, and fervent reverence for the almighty dollar. These were the druggy wastrels who had to be cleaned up like all the garbage that littered the streets. In gaming terms, there's nothing quite like having the ethical carte blanche to boot somebody right in the jewels. But even though Streets of Rage 4 is a DeLorean ride back to an era of simplistic moral and societal divisions, it neither revels nor fully elevates its subject into campy melodrama. Played perversely straight, there are judicious but subtle cleanups of the more unpalatable sprites from the early 90s for sure, and it's nice to see that the female characters from the originals aren't quite as objectified in provocative clobber. Developers Guard Crush Games couldn't get rid of the lurid sexism completely, of course, but a lot of the new design choices, like the biker gang and new boss Estelle, have wildly different proportions from each other and aren't just reduced to being pixelated provocateurs. In gameplay terms, Streets of Rage 4 has also been given a bit of modernization. Guard Crush have taken influence from mid-90s games like Guardian Heroes, with its combo input similar to Street Fighter 2. That's not to say Streets of Rage doesn't innovate though. They've improved sightlines, reduced stun lock situations, and prevented off-screen unblockables, all of which are very welcome changes. Despite the original games ripping off Final Fight's chunky visuals, right down to Axel being a home bargains Cody, this fourth entry has a unique appearance. It's very golden age comic book, with a halftone style creeping in at the edges. Funny enough, that makes it look more like Comic Zone than it does Streets of Rage 2 or 3. Whilst playing, you might also notice echoes of Doom 2016, where constant attack was the best form of defense. Without a block button, you're an exposed nerve out there, but there are maneuvers and a range of attacks that act as pauses or breathers. In Doom, these would be glory kills. In Streets of Rage 4, their defensive supers, and the ability to turn grapples into crowd-evading high vaults. Pre-built combos, basic zoning, and keepaways are all present and correct, and anyone can get a good blast out of the game utilizing the low difficulty settings. But the people who are really into this genre will spend weeks, months, and probably years perfecting their playstyle, choosing a character that fits them perfectly, working out all the timings, such as how long windups last, and when to use aerials or switch to chip damage. All that sort of tech tuning is finally dialed in. Spend any amount of time with Streets of Rage 4 and you'll quickly see that it's a labor of love. The game is a welcome flashback to an alternate 1995, one perhaps where devs had the power and the technology to really push the genre, but before it moved off in more sophisticated directions. And truth be told, there's nothing wrong with that. Guard Crush have polished a very particular game from a niche genre to a high sheen, just like restoring a classic car. Spray a little graffiti on the top, add some weathering, put a shirtless muscle man behind the wheel and a blousy broad in the passenger seat. Mount a Ronald Reagan bobblehead on the dash and send it off onto the streets of Brooklyn or Manhattan or Harlem, where pimps and junkies congregate, and brace yourselves for some neon-lit violence. That's your Streets of Rage 4.